The most momentous event of 1908 was the almost bloodless revolt by the Young Turks against the Ottoman Sultan. The Young Turks were motivated by the deteriorating state of affairs in the Balkans. Their revolt, which was supported by the Albanians and given further impetus by the declaration of independence of the Bulgarians from the Ottomans, forced the Sultan to agree to reestablish a constitution for the empire. The weakness of the Ottoman Empire allowed the Austrian-Hungarian Empire to extend its influence in the Balkans by claiming sovereignty to Bosnia and Herzegovina. The Austrian actions threatened Serbia and thus laid the seed of World War I. The Russians and the British managed during the course of the year to settle most of their differences. In South Africa, a young Indian named Mahatma Gandhi led nonviolent demonstrations against implementation of anti-Indian policy by the government of South Africa. The United States took a number of steps that helped cement its position as a world power. Its Great White Fleet sailed around the world in 1908, projecting American naval power worldwide. President Roosevelt requested money from Congress to build 4 modern battleships. During the year, President Roosevelt called a conference of the nation's governors to discuss ways of conserving America's wilderness. During the course of the year, the first rail tunnel was built under the Hudson River, replacing the slower ferry boats that had been used until then. It was also the year that Henry Ford began producing the Model T automobiles, the first mass-produced cars for the masses. The year was an important year in the history of aviation. Henry Farman became the first pilot to fly a plane in a circle in Europe. At the same time, the Wright brothers provided their first aircraft for the U.S. Army, and the first aircraft fatality occurred when a Wright flyer crashed, killing an Army trainee.